Yeah. Senator, thanks for your time. Is this result enough to save Tony Abbott?
This is a strong result for the Prime Minister. We can now put this issue of leadership behind us and continue to do that which the Australian people elected us to do, and that is to ensure the future of our nation economically, also with our borders, and ensure that we have a good international reputation. So from the family budget right through to the international reputation, they're the matters we've concentrated on, they're the matters we will continue to concentrate on.
Can you really put this behind you when 39 members of the party have voted for a spill of the leadership? That's about 4 out of 10.
This result is similar to that which Bill Shorten got out of his caucus when he was elected as leader. And of course, if you're an optimist like me, Tony Abbott got the leadership by one vote. 5 years later, that margin has increased by a long way.
But at that time, there was a challenger. This vote had not even a challenger. It was a vote for Tony Abbott or no one.
Well, I think the good news in the vote is that there is strong support for the Prime Minister, but it has also sent a message to the government that we need to listen more carefully, not only to the backbench, but more importantly, the public. And we get that message. We have received that message, and you will see changes in 2015. So I think the vote, in a way, was good. There was good, solid base for the Prime Minister to keep going, but it's also a degree of chastisement to have those 39 votes, and the Prime Minister gets that, and as a result the government will come together to ensure that we deliver for the Australian people.
So if you are going to listen to the Australian people, was there any commitment given to getting rid of some of the more unpopular policies, like, for example, the GP co-payment?
Some issues clearly are off the table, such as paid parental leave, such as prime ministerial knighthoods, and we'll see how that develops. But at the end of the day, what this is all about is ensuring good, sound government, like getting rid of the carbon and mining taxes, ensuring our borders are secure, getting free trade agreements, all of these things that a lot of people said we couldn't achieved within the first half of this government's term.
And the GP co-payment, that remains policy?
The GP co-payment is on the table, along with the other issues that Minister Lay is working through with the medical profession and other stakeholders, and we'll see where that lands. But as a government, we are determined to ensure that we bring the Australian people with us on this journey, which is a tough journey, because times are tough at the moment, with iron ore prices falling, with income to government falling. We do need to ensure that we have a sustainable future. That requires some tough decisions, but in making tough decisions, you need to bring the backbench and, most importantly, the Australian people with you.
And just finally, so you're confident that Tony Abbott will be Prime Minister at the time of the next election?
I am confident that the Prime Minister will be the Prime Minister at the 2016 election and also after it.
Senator Eric Abetz, thanks.